Let's do a little bonus video today and talk about some big scale Star Trek, the original series stuff going on. First up on top of here, Round 2 Models has released under the Polar Lights banner a brand new lighting kit for the 1/350th scale original series model of the Enterprise. All right, this thing has LED lighting, on and off switch, got the colored clear parts, engine fan motors, and no solder is required on this one. It all is just plug and play. Check it out. Colored lenses done for you, lighting in there for the cargo bay, the rotating engine fans. You can see it's got that cool LED detail. Now, it's got 95 total LEDs. It is a nice little kit. It's going to be available soon. I will link down in the description. This is for the kits. It will not work on the model, which I'm about to show you right now. This kit here, this absolute unit of a model kit. Look at the size of it just compared to my big mitt. From Polar Lights via Round 2 Models, sent this over for the show to take a look at. It is the display model, 1/350th scale, Star Trek, the NCC 1701. Not the A, not the B, not the C, not the D, not the E. The original, the very first from the original series. The box itself is gorgeous. You got Scotty, McCoy, Spock, Kirk over there. It is beautiful. We always like looking at the big display boxes. Check it out. We got Majel Barrett. We got Chekhov on this side. We got Uhura. We got Sulu. They did such a beautiful job just on the box itself. I always like showing that off. The marketing and graphic design team always does such a nice job. Let's see if we can unbox it right on the show here. We're going to be putting this together. There's not many parts to it. It is huge and held together with a lot of friction. Oh, you open it up, you see the gigantic saucer section, all weathered. Look at that. It is ginormous, all painted and done. Now, I don't have the time to do a full 1/350th scale Enterprise, so this is exactly what a guy like me needs when you want to display something that big in this scale and enjoy it. So this is available right now. Let's see what else we can get out of here. Oh, it all lifts out. Okay, hold on. Let's get some stuff out of the way here. Let's get the destructions out. Let's get the huge box out of the way. I may need that to live in if I keep getting more model kits here. So we got this nice... We got the instructions here. So there's not even that many parts to it. We got the nacelles with their supports. We got the main hull. We got the saucer. We got the radome. We got a support rod and the Polar Lights base. So we got all that together. It looks like assembly is just a snap lock affair. Let's see. Got more packaging. Ooh. Get that shiny plastic off there. And it's heavy. It's heavy. Look at the weathering on that. Oh, man. Get up close. We got panel lines. We got, I mean, it's decals or something, but there's nothing, it doesn't stand proud. Look at that. It's not like a shiny film around it. Oh, we got phasers. We got registration. The lights are painted. Unfortunately, you can't take this apart and put that lighting kit in it. We got the impulse area. So you won't be able to light this one unless you want to completely rip it apart. But they do have the clear parts. Tinted. Oh, this is just exquisite. We got that big base down there. What do we got here? We got a nacelle. Oh, even those are weathered. Ooh. Check that. Oh my God. It's like a metallic tint in the vents all the way down in there. I couldn't do a job this good. This is so cool. All the logos. This has got to be painted on somehow or something. I'm not really sure. Maybe it is a giant overlay, but you certainly can't tell. At least I can't by looking at it. We'll get the other nacelle. We'll get the radome out. And that cool gold. They run these, if you get the like the Heroes and Icons network, I'm not shilling for a TV network, but They play the original series, followed by the Next Generation, followed by Deep Space Nine, Voyager, and Enterprise every night. So if there's nothing else on the boob tube, it's got nice attachments and click points there. Oh, that's nice. Look at the weathering on that. That is so sweet. I'm digging these metal grills in here. Really big time. All that paintwork and weathering work all done for you. Got the back of the nacelles. I mean, that's my arm. This thing is so huge. I love that. I'm trying to gently place these on the side. We've got extra large base with reinforcements on the bottom. You could paint that up, make it look like a planet. Maybe I'll do that. I don't know. When I assemble this, maybe I'll give that a coat of primer. We'll get that painted up to look like a planet. We'll see. We got our metal rod for that stand. Nice tubular metal, all chromed out, looking sharp. And now, gently, take that out of the side. Wow! What's that called? The primary hull? It's got the window decals. Check that out, how deep. That is sweet. Oh, I don't know where I'm going to put this in my house, but it is enormous. All the little numbers all the way along. Look at the bottom. Got our cargo bay that doesn't open that I know of. No, that is closed. The shuttle bay back there. All that neat weathering around the nacelles. On that upper shaft, going up to the saucer section, got like a turbo lift, go up in there. This is just amazing. So all these parts, we got the two nacelles. We got the dome on the front, the deflector. We got the saucer section. All these just snap fit together. That's all they do. And then we'll put that on the base. And you know what? Let's get over it. Let's do this. Let's do a little paint work on here and see what we can do. So follow me over to the paint area. I'm going to get to work on this. And then I'm going to snap all these parts together, which shouldn't take... What an outstanding model. And you get what would take, you know, your average time would take weeks to do. You get it done in mere seconds. Now, I went and detailed that base. I did not make it any bright colors. You could do Jupiter, Saturn, any of the planets that you wanted to, or imaginary planets, or things from other shows by adding craters and all that stuff to it with some silly putty or painting over it and stuff like that. I just wanted to get it so that it wasn't a high gloss black. I might even paint the shaft here a flat black when I'm done. But the entire model goes together so easily and balances beautifully. Arrived defect free. You saw all the close-ups. I'm gonna have other pictures as well at the end of the video so you can get a still shot and a close-up. But this thing barely fits on my display table. I set up a display table just for this thing with a backdrop because it was so big and it would never fit on my regular workbench. I don't know where I'm gonna put this in my home. It might be right as a big centerpiece somewhere because it is exquisite. No one is going to have something like this unless you buy it, because look at this thing. I can't believe it's huge. It is like 34 inches long, 32 inches long. Massive model kit. The saucer section is 15 inches wide. The entire kit from that base is over a foot tall, 13 inches. I love this thing. I'm so glad Round 2 is producing these for those of us that want a giant scale enterprise but simply don't have the time to build it. And don't forget, they got the new light kit out. If you want to build your own enterprise and get it completely lit, I've seen those done and they are exquisite and they're going to look wonderful. So don't forget that. As you can see, it balances perfectly on its stand. I'm surprised the turntable can turn this thing. It is such a gorgeous model. Look at the fit under there of the saucer. No huge seams where the nacelles are or anything. And it just looks lovely. We're going to stall that turntable out. I don't know. I'm just still surprised that it still goes around. So thanks a lot to Round 2 Models. I will link down in the description where you can snag these display kits from them. These are a very limited production. So once they are gone, they are gone. And who knows, maybe the next edition will have lights. That would be recommended. Maybe, or be able to retrofit lights. Who knows? That would be cool. But this as itself is super awesome. And I can't wait to see what other 1/350th scale ships they do in this pre-built design. I think it's absolutely lovely. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks for supporting the show with your sweet comments and nice words. And we will see all of you at the next review.